Ladies and gentlemen, the following feature contest is for the World Television Championship and is set for one fall. Introducing first the challenger, being led to the ring by Colonel Robert Parker from Bucksport, Tennessee, weighing 253 pounds, Bunkhouse Buck.
Well, Bucksport, Tennessee. I wonder if they've ever seen anything like the Renegade in downtown Bucksport.
I doubt that seriously, brother. I'm telling you, Renegades don't run around in Bucksnot late at night.
If so, they meet someone like Colonel Parker's pride and joy, Bunkhouse Buck. Very successful in this sport. Back we go to Dave Penzer.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, the World Television Champion, the Renegade!
Hang on now, here he comes! And he's getting in the ring so quickly, he left Jimmy Hart!
Well, he's high energy, brother. Always moving. Oh, man, you just got to be able to control him in a situation now. Bunkhouse Buck has to be able to take away all this movement from this guy, or he'll be discombobulated this whole match right here on the prime.
You don't want to get discombobulated. No question about that.
Got them big old tattoos, arms on his shoulders.
The Renegade and Buck.
You're the man out here. He belongs to you, Buck.
Little pep talk going on there.
Yes, sir. He's trying to get him right. Trying to get him right. As you said, his pride and joy right there. That's one way to get him right. Get him outside and stop this.
Pounding away, Buck and Renegade. Whoa. Renegade picks him up.
Ooh.
Oh. That hurt me. And you know it hurt Buck.
Yeah, that'll make your back crack and your liver quiver right there. Make your knees freeze. Old Buck is on the move, too.
Side headlock.
Well, that's unusual for the Renegade. Side headlock.
It is. Usually just runs right through you.
That's what
away.
I'm talking about, Tom.
And he holds on. Uh-oh. Buck moved him into the corner. He snatches a headlock again.
Yeah, but he wasn't in a position now when he moved him in to get loose from that.
Down goes Bunkhouse Buck. Wow, back body drop.
Yeah, took him for the ride right there. Guarantee it. Now Buck is going to go back out to Colonel Parker and try to get his rep attendant straight.
The best rep attendant he can do right now is just to stay right there.
Well, he's about lost his suspenders, his draws, everything else. But he's trying to stop the Renegade's onslaught.
And that is, fans, an onslaught.
Get in there.
Colonel Parker, he's giving instructions.
It's awfully easy to say, get in there and get him when you're standing outside there, isn't it?
Exactly, and that's what he's telling him. Got that cigar puffing down.
Yeah, there's a pit bull loose in the house, son. Get in there and get him while I stay on the back porch.
That's it, brother.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, sir, Tom. Right back to that headlock there.
Yeah, how about that?
Well, he's ragtagging him, too, with it. Got him to his knees. Oh man, if he's putting some power on that noggin, if you will.
Bunkhouse Buck trying to escape this and certainly expending a lot of energy trying to get out of it. He's out though, and now here he goes. Bunkhouse Buck doing what he knows best. And that pounding away. Didn't take long. We got a sleeper hold.
Well, he's got that thing hooked. I don't know how well he's got it hooked or what he knows about the sleeper, but he had worked on his head. I guarantee you that.
He's got something on there.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's the sleeper. He's got it on.
Yeah, well, Buck made it to the rope.
Clothesline. Buck goes over the top of the floor.
Well, Colonel Parker is irate.
Well, Colonel ought to roll in there and shake him a little bit.
Well, need to fan him up, get him back. You know, he's buying time. Even, you know, Bunkhouse Buck laying out there. As long as he keeps the Renegade station there, he's okay. Look at him, giving him some encouragement.
And the Renegade, for the first time in the match, calmly waiting. And he waited in the corner till Buck came in. And here he goes again. Well, he has one type of strategy here, and that's to yank on that head.
Yeah, as I said, he ragtagged that old head there, and there's something different for Bunkhouse Buck to be in there and get ragtagged like that. Whoa! Yes! Hey, ref! Tripped him, Tony.
Colonel Parker tripped him, you're right, and that enables the hard-soled cowboy boots to crash against the head of Renegade.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's the equalizer right there, standing outside
that
ring.
You do your job, I'm not bothering you out here.
Bigfoot Renegade goes down on that one.
All right, let's see here now. Buck's strategy has changed drastically from that trip by Colonel Parker.
Now in the ring, riding like a Brahma bull. Was that your line?
No, well, you used okay. it. Yeah, my mama gonna be mad at you.
A pickup and a hard slam.
Well, at least it's all, you know. Yeah, he's going up top. This might be a mistake.
That's a big one.
Oh, whoa. Whoa.
And that will make a buck snort.
Yes, it will.
Oh, my goodness.
That's my line, too.
Yeah, good.
That's good. He got both of them, man. Who's been talking to you? I'm rubbing off on Tony, man.
In the ropes. Here's the power slam. Wow.
Uh-oh. Well, he's awful far out there, Tony, if he's going for what I think he is. He's a long way across that ring.
A long way is right. If he connects, he'll hold on to the title. Oh, he did.